What's up, everyone? We're gonna be looking at a 2001 Ford F150 4.2 liter. We're gonna be swapping out the intake manifold control runner. I decided to make the video because I don't think I found a video online. So yeah, I hope this helps you out. First off, I ain't no mechanic. I just like doing this. Like saving money, so I always try to do it myself first before taking it to a mechanic. But first off, well, this part here is from a junkyard. Got it for $16.99. I normally like buying my stuff new, but the OEM was like $329. Then I found like Amazon, same thing for like $176, and this one I found it for $16.99 at the junkyard. If you do go with the junkyard, so just take a good three. If it's cheap, if it's worth it. I only got one because it's the best one I found. So I'm over here also going to see. I mean, yeah, I guess I could have gone with a newer one, but since I'm a college student, I'm quite in a budget. So, yeah. And I hope this video helps. First off, we need a 10 millimeter. You can use a wrench or a drill. This angled flat screwdriver. I forgot the exact name for it. 8 millimeter socket, a flathead, and a cheetah bar. Eventually, gonna need it. It's always helpful. First off, we're going to remove this air intake. I'm gonna remove the screw here. If yours is the original air intake, still you probably have here like a same their flathead or like some kind of clip. Remove that. We remove this little sensor here. We're gonna remove this. On mine, I remove the sensor connector. On yours, if it's the original, in the back, you remove this whole thing right here. And I'm eventually gonna be pausing it because I'm using a phone. So bear with me on that. Now that you have removed the air intake, now we can remove the throttle body. It's four screws, two here, two in the bottom. There are 10 millimeters. Also, we can remove this, EGR valve, 2 millimeters as well. Remove this cable, accelerator cable, throttle cable, whatever you want to call it. And remove this throttle body sensor. Has two Phillips screws. Move that. And hold on. So there you go. Actually, you didn't have to. You could just remove the connector. The whole throttle body comes out. So yeah, just four screws, 10 millimeters. Move. Just throttle here, I mean your EGR. Just move. Next thing is remove these three spark plug wires, because all this is gonna move and this is gonna run away. So just remove them and put them in order, so you can just, when you put it back, you can know just, oh, this is number one, number two, or so forth. Now, after removing, the throttle body and the EGR, now we're removing this hose right here. This one right here. And this other one right here. So it's three of them, basically. Mine is, I can use flathead, but if I'm not mistaken, most Fords come with this type on their hoses, smaller depending on the size or whatever. I normally remove it with a needle nose, or you can use any pliers that works for you. Just be careful with this one. This one should have coolant, so you are gonna have a small leak. So I suggest, depending on what you're working at, put a cardboard on the bottom, or you can fit some kind of little cup here. I'm just gonna let it spill. Eventually, just gonna stick it somewhere up here so it won't be spilling. Just tie it with a zip tie. I'm gonna remove it and then show you how, and then show how I tied it up or whatever. Now, if you were having trouble by any chance removing any of these other hoses, what I did was just remove this whole thing with two screws and basically pop it out. Remove that. And you remove this screw right here, which is holding these big hoses. You don't have to remove the hoses, it's just this little bracket. You have to remove it. Also, let's see if I get a better look. This little like vacuum hose and the connection and these little, let's see this right here has two little hoses on it. Remove those. Yeah, so you can stop the video just to make sure and see on yours. So now that we remove all the little vacuum hoses and connections on this side that are connected to this little plenum, we can now start removing the screws. There are a total 1, 2, 3, 4. There are about 12 screws. You can have like 4 in the back, 1 on this side, another on this side, and 1 or 2 in the middle. The ones in the back, you're basically gonna have to feel them out. And all of them are 10 millimeters. So if you have, you know, drill, you can remove all the ones. And the ones you can't reach with the drill, they use a small one of these or a small ratchet. For 10 millimeters all around.